So if you need to be tested for a coronavirus infection, what they'll do is the doctor or nurse will take a swab from inside your mouth, sample some of the saliva, and they'll send it away to look for the presence of coronavirus genes in your saliva. That's all it is. It's fairly simple, pain-free, straightforward. How long is a piece of string? Vaccine production used to take 20 years. It's much shorter these days, down to a few years. But it is a few years, not a few months or a few weeks, as some people have suggested. There won't be a coronavirus vaccine in any usable quantity, if at all, any time this year, I don't think. It will be at least 18 months before the vaccine comes along. We don't yet know whether a summer season will reduce the toll of viral infection, or this viral infection, because we haven't experienced it through a summer. It's not an unreasonable expectation, because we know that people are generally less susceptible during summer months than they are during winter months. But there is a coronavirus which is endemic in the human population, which causes the common cold. And MERS, another coronavirus, was worst in the Middle East during the summer. So while most coronavirus infections are worse during the winter, not all of them are, and it might be the case with this. Well, people probably need to wash their hands more than they likely do already. That's a really good way of reducing the chances of getting infected, because when you get the virus on your hands, you're more likely, when you touch your mouth, your nose, your eyes, to get yourself infected. So reduce the amount of time you touch your face, keep your hands clean. That's probably the best precaution to use. Of course, some people are using an elbow bump instead of shaking hands, but that's a matter of personal preference. Yes, if we see a really big upswing in the numbers of infections across the UK, we may see the health authorities, the government, impose some movements on people's restrictions and people's gatherings. But exactly what those are, we don't know yet. And there really is no point in putting those measures in place until they're needed, until we've got enough people that we can control using them. Otherwise, it's a waste of time. If they're immunocompromised, the best thing is to keep yourself clean and keep them clean. Wash your hands all the time, be careful where you put your hands, and make sure before you cross the threshold into your house that you've washed your hands or used hand sanitizer or whatever. Try and reduce the possibility of bringing virus into the home. Of course, if they're severely immunocompromised, then the hospital will be keeping an eye on them anyway. So just be mindful of the risk that they face as well. If you're prone to colds, it's probably because you just get infected more. And the reason you get infected more is that you vector stuff to your face via your hands, probably more than other people. So the best advice is to improve your hand hygiene, reduce the amount of times you touch your face. No. The government's advice at the moment is to dial 111 if you're having shortness of breath, if you're having coughing symptoms. The NHS online will give you more details. No, just because you get a simple cough doesn't mean you have to self-isolate. That advice might change though, so watch that space. I wouldn't bother with either. The mask, the best thing it will really do is stop you from touching your mouth or your nose. It won't stop you touching your eyes, which is a potential route to infection. I'm not bothering with them because the fibres in those masks that you see, whether they're those sort of operating theatre masks or the dust masks you can get from a DIY store, are too big, the pores in them are too big to stop a tiny little virus going through them. So if somebody coughs or sneezes virus over you, it will go straight through you. As for gloves, Well, we know from settings like this in a laboratory that when people wear gloves on their hands, they're less conscious that they've touched things like door handles and cupboard handles and things like that. They're likely to spread things around more. The best thing you can do is to keep your hands clean. Absolutely. Until the government decides that it's unsafe to do so, then carry on enjoying your life. You'd have to meet, currently, about 200,000 people before you met one person with this coronavirus in the UK. So the chances are that you're not going to meet somebody with it yet. No. The virus gets into you, gets into your airways, it replicates. Warm food, which isn't much hotter than your body temperature anyway, goes straight down your gullet and into your stomach. No, having warm drinks will make you feel better possibly, but it won't kill the virus. I was asked the other day if ginger tea was any use. No, don't bother with anything like that. Yes. Carry on enjoying your life until we know that it's essential that people of certain groups need to restrict their movements. Just enjoy your life. Don't worry about it. People say to me all the time, oh, I've got flu, when in actual fact they've just got a cold. The two are quite different. A flu is much more severe than a cold, and I think we're expecting many people who experience symptoms to get more flu-like symptoms than cold-like symptoms. People won't want to get out of bed, they will be running a temperature, they will be feeling really quite unwell and unable to function rather than just feeling a bit under the weather.